Welcome back, everybody. Our next guest is the owner of Honey Salt Restaurants in Las Vegas and Vancouver and the author of the brand new cookbook, Honey Salt, a Culinary Scrapbook. And today she is in our kitchen making cast iron corned beef hash that everybody is going to want for brunch this weekend. Please welcome Elizabeth Blau to our home. Welcome, Elizabeth. I know it's only Monday, but we're getting some ideas for the family coming up here. As you can see, our family was very excited about your corned beef hash, so you guys dig in. So Elizabeth, you are you're a culinary expert, I would say, of a different sort, because you really did single-handedly change the face of Las Vegas dining.
Well, thank you.
She really did.
Yeah, I had some help, but it was really extraordinary building the Bellagio and the Wynn and bringing all the celebrity chefs, Todd English, Michael Mina, Jean George, and just a real host of amazing people to the city.
But before her, there weren't many celebrity chefs in Vegas. You're the one who really opened up the floodgates, and then everybody else followed suit.
Thank you.
It's true. You did an amazing thing, and now Las Vegas is
a culinary mecca.
100%. So, you know what? Congratulations on that.
Well, thank you.
For that. I love that.
Thank you.
No small feat. And your corned beef hash is as impressive as what you did with Las Vegas, I will tell you that. So, everybody knows corned beef hash is nothing without the potatoes.
Yes.
The potatoes are really a big part of this. And it's very important that the potatoes that we make for the corned beef hash go into cold water, not boiling water.
This is a trick my husband taught me. And if you put them in cold water, then they cook evenly and give you this really nice texture. So what I'm going to do, we've cut these, and I'm going to pour them into the boiling water. And then
the cold water, not boiling.
Excuse me.
Cold. The boiling water, it'll all kind of fall apart.
It will fall apart and will not look pretty in your hash.
Right.
So we have them in the cold water, and then it gets to a boil. And then when it gets to a boil, you want to cook it for about 10 to 15 minutes so they get nice and soft.
Okay, and then you're going to pull them out and we're going to put them back in our skillet. So over here in our skillet, in the meantime, we have our aromatics going.
So we've got some onions, some peppers, but really the great thing about this dish is you can raid your fridge and use any kind of leftovers, any kind of vegetables to, you know, the thing about a hash is it's meant to be creative.
Right. From the night before or anything through the week. And do you have that with olive oil or butter?
So I like to use a little olive oil and sneak a little butter
Ooh,
in there.
I love that. That's
as
nice.
Well. So you want to cook these about 7 to 10 minutes so that you get a nice caramelization.
Okay.
And so what I would normally do is put these in and so they get a nice caramelly, but these already have
already browned.
A head start to them.
And then we drop them back in there. And then the star of the show, of course, the corned beef, which you make your own corned beef, right?
So at the restaurant, we definitely pickle and corn the beef. Mm. You cook it in a Dutch oven pot, and you can do it at home. It makes this a more complicated recipe, but there's nothing like that.
I didn't even know it was a verb to corn beef.
Yes.
It's an actual thing.
So we're going to put the corned beef in. Again, just mix till you get a nice golden brown.
Oh, that smells so good. Mm-hmm. And then we add our spices.
Now, this recipe, again, gives a little bit more flavor. There's a lot of spice. So this is a little cumin.
Nice. I like the spice. It's like the perfect amount.
Oh, thank you. And a little coriander.
Beautiful.
And, you know, at home, my son, he's 13, Cole will not eat this with all the spices. So I just take a little bit out for him.
You separate it.
I separate it. And, you know, again, you can really get as creative as you want.
How long would we keep the hash going?
The hash should go just again till everything is mixed and is looking really
what are you thinking,
delicious.
5-6 minutes?
And yeah, again, you've cooked all of these individual components.
Right, you just want to get them heated up and combined really well.
And then at the very end, that's when you want to add your chives and your parsley. But you want to keep the green, so you want to do this at the very end.
When you take it off the heat.
After great flavors, though, really. Mm.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
And I appreciate your use of sriracha.
Wow, we like a little spice in our kitchen at home. And so if you do like spicy, then this is just, you just add a little bit at the end.
Okay.
Now you just mix it all nicely.
Oh. Now, and I know you're serving this with a beautiful frittata.
Yeah, so corned beef hash is a great side dish, and so you can use it with a, you can poach an egg, you can scramble an egg, but today we're doing this beautiful frittata, which is also a recipe in the book.
There you go.
Frittata has like is it
yeah. Look at that.
Tomatoes in it that is so good.
Yeah. Tomatoes.
This is like spinach.
And again, the wonderful thing about this dish is you can just use what you have in the refrigerator. You obviously need to start with the eggs, but today we've got the beautiful potatoes and some basil and spinach in there.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Now, in your new cookbook, Honey, Salt, a Culinary Scrapbook, it is just that. It is a scrapbook. So how did you kind of put it all together?
Well, I love scrapbooking, and so that's how we chronicle kind of our vacations and family adventures, so I don't have just boxes of pictures.
Okay.
And so it was kind of a natural evolution to turn our making of our restaurant into a culinary scrapbook.
Oh, nice.
So it tells the story through journeys and through all kinds of...
look at that, of the family. And beautiful recipes from your travels all around the world and all around America. Let's take a look at some of these beautiful recipes. The first one, obviously, I love how simple the cover of the book is, by the way. The first one, obviously, is from Italy.
This was trips to Italy and just learning to master a perfect bolognese.
Oh, I love bolognese more than anything.
The bucatini.
Oh, again, Italy. Oh.
Italy, the panettone, and again, whatever seasonal fruits are in. This happens to be raspberry, but you can use whatever.
That's a very traditional Italian cake.
And then we move to the Cape Cod section.
Oh, my goodness.
Look at that.
That is, I mean, that reminds me of my youth.
A little chorizo.
Oh, yeah. I mean, and of course, Old Bay seasoning.
The Old Bay.
I mean, Old Bay seasoning. Anyone who lives on the East Coast or even Southern East Coast, like, you put Old Bay on a plate and you would eat it. Like, it's so delicious.